morning and welcome to The Grove. I'm Joy Robbins and these are your weekly announcements. If you would like to join us in our weekly corporate prayer call on Wednesday, use the number on your screen to call in. We have a brief meditation and time of sharing prayer requests. We are blessed with an abundance of great cooks here at The Grove and they love to feed you. Food and fellowship are ways we can stay connected during these times. We have been blessed to provide a meal every Saturday for more than a year now. Come and get a lunch on Saturday between 2 and 4 p.m. Join us at The Grove each Sunday morning at 9 a.m. for Sunday school. There are classes for all age groups. Yes, this is a season of gratitude and thanksgiving, but many are struggling at this time due to loss or illness. It means so much to hear from you. Simply calling, sending a text, or dropping a card in the mail can lift someone's spirits. Let's bear one another's burdens, particularly in this holiday season. If you've never reached out to a fellow member, I challenge you to do so this week. We will host a COVID vaccination clinic here at The Grove on Saturday from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. Booster shots for adults and vaccines for children ages 5 to 11 will be available. Calling all children and youth, stay after service to help with an important missionary project. Details are on the screen. In November, National Diabetes Month focuses attention on the growing toll of diabetes on America's health. From the physical, emotional, and social effects to the financial and damaging health consequences, diabetes impacts more than 30 million people in the United States. Also known as American Diabetes Month, this month focuses on making healthy changes and reducing the risk of type 2 diabetes. Get a physical. Regular checkups let us know where we stand and what changes we need to make. Ask questions too. When we make small changes, we are more likely to stick with them. So add one or two small changes at a time instead of huge sweeping changes. Let's take care of the whole person. We want you to be well spiritually, emotionally, and physically. China Grove and friends, have a wonderful week. Stay up to date with everything that's going on here at The Grove by subscribing to our website, www.chinagroveamezion.org. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and check us out on YouTube. Join us in service that's already in progress.
Clothes on our back and shoes on our feet and food to eat. God, we thank you for providing for us and protecting us every single day of this week from dangers seen and unseen. God, this time we ask that you would be here with us to bless us, to have your way in this service, and allow us and help us to just let go of ourselves and decrease so that you can increase, so that you may have your way, so that we can be free and free in you. We bless your name in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
China Grove, you know this song. Amen. We need you to sing with us. We're gonna move around a whole lot so we can stay warm out here. Yeah. Hallelujah.
I wanna clap a little louder than before. I wanna sing louder than before. Deeper than before. I want to shout louder. Say freedom.
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 The sun sets free.
Freedom.
He is free indeed.
Freedom.
Say freedom.
Freedom.
No longer bound. Than before.
No more chains, no more bondage. I am free. Yeah. Can you help me say? No more shackles, no more chains, no more bondage. I am free. Yeah. Praise team, y'all sound like y'all believe that. Let's say it again. Say no more, no more, no more. With us, say no more, no more, no more, no more. Free, yeah. So we're gonna seal it with a praise. Say hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Shackles, no more chains, no more bondage. I am free. Yeah. Can y'all make that declaration? Say no more shackles, no more chains, no more. I am free. Now make it personal. Speak to those things that are trying to keep you bound. Tell them no more, no more, no more, no more.
Yeah.
story, whatever situation that you are going through, God has you. He has you in the palm of his hands. Don't worry. Like I said, you might not be the best of whatever you do, but do your best and God will be pleased. Never be bound again. Never, ever be bound again. I have my liberty, and so do you. Because you know why? Chains ago, I have a new song. I'm finally free. Chains ago, I have a new song. I'm finally free. Help me.
Chains ago, I have a new song.
Come on, if that's your testimony today, you ought to say, thank you, Jesus, that I'll never be bound again. Any free people who can say, I thank the Lord that I've been set free. No more chains are holding me. I'll never, ever be bound again. Come on, you ought to give God thanks and praise for setting you free. Come on, you ought to thank him today for giving you new life. You ought to thank him today for releasing you from the bondage that you were held in. I will never be bound again. Hallelujah. We praise God for this opportunity of worship. We thank God for all of you being in this worship space. Thank God for those of you braving this wind under the tent. Amen. God praise for you. Be praised for you today. Amen. Thank God for each of you who are in your cars. Amen. Good morning, folks in your cars. Amen. Good morning. Good morning to those of you who are joining us via live stream. Good morning to you as well. We're just happy to have another day to give God praise, another day to give him glory. Amen, somebody. Amen. I've learned to thank God for one more day. Amen. To be thankful for the day he has allowed me to see. And we're so grateful and thankful to him for all that he continues to do. Listen, amen. It is a little nippy out here. Amen. But that does not have to stop our praise today. Amen. We can still give God praise even in this moment. Thank God for you. Listen, I just want to reiterate today something you heard in our announcements. I want you to go and look on our webpage and all of our platforms that we have, because on next Saturday between the hours of 10 and 2, we're going to have the vaccine here for our children. Amen. The vaccine here for our children and those who may need the first shot. I'm sure you could get it. And we will also have the booster shot here on our campus. Amen. That you could come next Saturday to get it between the hours of 10 and 2. Now listen, you know, I don't know why folk like messing with me. Amen. At China Grove. But those of you who are anti-vaxxers and all of that stuff, stay off our page. Did you hear me? God uses different methods and means to keep us safe. Amen. I believe in divine healing. Yes, I do. I believe we in divine healing. But I also believe that God uses different methods and means to help us stay safe and healed. Amen. And for those of you who are, you know, well, I ain't getting the vaccine, I ain't taking no shot, I don't know what's in it. You ate at McDonald's last night. When you had a headache, you took a Tylenol. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I can't get nothing out of this Presbyterian church today. So stay off our page with all that nonsense. Amen, somebody. Lord, the security team, like, here we go again. Amen, amen, amen. But we want those of you who need to come get this shot and have not had your vaccine and the children, amen, I'm ready for us to have to take these masks off. Amen. I'm ready. I'm tired of wearing a mask. And I'm ready to take it off. So it's, they have a way and a method for us to do so. So we invite you to come and on next Saturday to be here between the hours of 10 and 2 to come get the vaccine. Amen? Amen, amen, amen. Listen. It is getting colder. Amen. It is getting colder. Amen. It is getting colder. Yeah, man. Amen. And it's time for us to prepare ourselves. And because our numbers in Mecklenburg County have decreased in such a manner, it's time for us to start going back into our sanctuary. Amen. And we're going to start preparing ourselves for that. Our official Sunday for going back will be December. First Sunday in December will be our official Sunday where we will open up between 50 and 75% capacity. But we're inviting those of you who come to church to help us. We need your help because we want to make sure that our process is smooth. So over the next 3 Sundays, we're going to need some folk to come to church and to register. It starts with your registration with our Eventbrite, I think it's called. Eventbrite. You register through Eventbrite. Let us know you're coming so we could be prepared for you. We're going to be safe. Listen to me, China Grove. I am one that does not believe in just doing stuff because everybody else is doing it. But I believe it's time for us, China Grove, hear me, to practice our good faith with good sense, and we're going to go and try to worship, because I don't want our worship to stop. Amen. Amen. We're going to wear our mask. I don't care what the county says. I don't care what the state says. We're going to wear our mask. We're going to continue to take temperatures. We're going to socially distance. Amen. We're not going to be sitting on top of each other. But we want to continue to worship God. And I want you to be in worship. I need to see your faces. I think I preach better when I see y'all. Amen. Y'all help me. Y'all, this is a preaching church. Amen. So we want you to register, but we need you to register. If you need help registering, call us and we will help you do so. Amen. We want you to register so we'll know who's coming, so we can prepare, so we can be ready for you. But we're going to practice over the next couple Sundays, and first Sunday of December, we're going to give it a full throttle, all right? Can y'all work with me on that? Everybody happy about that? All right. Good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff. Listen, now it's time for us to participate in worship through our giving. Amen. And let me say to you, China Grove, you have done a phenomenal job of supporting ministry. You have done a phenomenal job, and we want to continue to forge ahead. We want to continue to give. Amen. Whatever the Lord lays on your heart, amen. We want those who tithe to tithe, amen, and those who give offering to give an offering. But we want everybody to give. We want you to continue to give, that ministry can continue. We can continue to do what God has called us to do and be a blessing to the kingdom of God. Amen. All of the things that we do is because you support ministry. Amen. You support ministry. And we're able to continue ministry because you support it. And we want you to continue to do so as God has blessed us. Let's pray as we get ready to give. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to give. We thank you, oh God, that you have blessed us to give. You give seed to the sower. You make possible the opportunity for us to be a blessing. And so, God, we just ask now as we prepare to give today that you, God, will open up the windows of heaven and pour us out a blessing we don't have room enough to receive. We pray today, God, that you would make ready, God, the hearts of your people to receive the blessings that you have promised us for being faithful, God. We don't give out of necessity. We don't give, God, because someone asked us to give. We give, God, because we love you and we love your church. And we love, God, the opportunity to be a blessing. So we thank you, oh God. We praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Come on, those of you who are giving, if you need someone to come to your car, our attendants will come and assist you today. And those of you under the tent, those of you who need to call the church, the number should be on the screen. Amen. And the other means of giving that we have. Amen. Listen, we're going to let this praise team continue to bless us in singing. Amen. This is the first Sunday. We're going to serve communion today. We're going to have a wonderful worship experience as we continue. Come on, let's continue to lift up the name of Jesus as we worship him today. How many glad they brought you through this and they brought you through that? Come on, put your hands on it. Come on. We got to just do it one time. Can we just do it one time? Here we go. Come on. Say, I'm so grateful. Together to you. Hallelujah. Put those hands together if you're really grateful today. Hallelujah. He's worthy of our praise today. Amen. And we thank God. Amen. For this opportunity to worship. Amen. Thank you, praise team and music ministry and everybody who has made worship possible today. Amen. All of our camera operators and sound folk, amen. Amen. there is a word from the Lord today, and we're going to move expeditiously to the word. Amen. It's found in Hebrews 9. For preaching privilege today, I just want to read one verse, just one verse of Hebrews 9 here on this Communion Sunday. And it says this: how much more then will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleanse our consciousness from acts that lead to death, so that we may serve the living God? Amen. How much more then will the blood of Christ? That's enough for preaching right there. And I want to talk for just a few minutes from the simple thought, the benefits of his blood, the benefits of the blood. Amen. Pray with us. Father, we need preaching anointing today. We don't want any flesh to be on parade. But God, as we preach this sermon today, we want you to have preeminence in this space. Show us where you're working, and we will meet you right there. Help us not to preach a good sermon, but to preach one that will do some good. Let the words of our mouth, the meditation of our heart, be acceptable and pleasing in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. The benefit of the blood. The benefit of Jesus' blood. Brothers and sisters, as we come today, I have an admission to you that first Sunday is typically my favorite Sunday in the month. Even as a child, first Sunday is my favorite Sunday. And the reason for that, brothers and sisters, is even as a child, I used to like it because we got a snack in the middle of church. Some of y'all will get that later on. We got a snack in the middle of church. But Treasure, it also became my favorite Sunday because I learned that God had done so much for us when he gave his son Jesus Christ. As a teenager, and I went to Vacation Bible School, and I started hearing and learning about the sacrifice of Jesus at Calvary, it gave me, brothers and sisters, a sense of gratitude and praise and happiness, which made me want to thank God that I was saved. If you don't know my story, I'll tell you my story of how I became saved. I was 13 years old going to Smith Junior High School here in the city of Charlotte. That's when they used to call it junior high school. I was in class, and I had a teacher to witness to me in my health class, and Mr. Hicks, and he witnessed to us. And I say on that day is the day that I accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. I'm saved, brothers and sisters. I'm saved. I'm blood washed, and I'm glad about it. I wonder how many of you out there can say I'm saved and I'm glad about it. I'm saved. I make no bones about it. I make no things about it. I'm glad that God has saved me. I'm glad that God has set me free through his son, Jesus Christ. And as we come on Communion Sunday, it's a time for us to reflect and to remember what God has done for us through his son, Jesus. It's a time for us to remember how he sacrificed his life at Calvary for each one of us. It's a time for us to remember that God gave his very best when he gave us his son, Jesus. I had an interesting conversation one day, brothers and sisters, with a young man. He made the statement that that most Christians focus their attention on what they have been brought out of and where they have come from and where they're going. And this young man, brothers and sisters, began to make a case that Christianity, that Christians were too focused on the fact that they had been saved and delivered and set free. They always talk about being saved and being delivered and set free. And every time you talk to a Christian, that's all they talk about. And he was making the case, brothers and sisters, that Christianity seemed to be mundane.
mundane. It seemed to be boring, that Christians did not have fun because their conversation was only centered on the sacrifice of Christ and what he had done for them. And if all Christianity is based on being changed and being set free, where is the fun in it? Where is the new life? Where is the happy times? All you talk about is how you were in this and how you were in that, and God brought you out, and all of those things. And he was trying to make a case to me, and as I was listening to him, he almost caught my attention. He almost had me nod my head in agreement, but then the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me and said to me, that's what it's all about. The fact that, brothers and sisters, God did something for us that we could never do for ourselves. There is not enough in us. There is not enough about us that could have changed our lives the way that God has changed our lives. But do I have anybody out there to help me preach? I'm glad that I'm saved. I'm glad that God set me free. And because he did what I could not do, the life I now live is anew. I'm fresh. I'm free. And listen, I can tell you today, I have a good time being saved. I have a good time rejoicing in the Lord. You don't know what it really is to live until you start living for God. You really don't know what it is. Christ has done a lot for us. And without Christ's redeeming power altering the course of our life, none of us would be here. None of us would have the opportunities that we have. None of us, brothers and sisters, would share in this joy. That's why you ought to be excited. That's why you get happy. Not because you go to a particular church or you're under a particular denomination. Not because you're listening to a particular pastor. But you're excited because you know the blood has benefits in it. You know that the blood of Christ has done more for you than anybody else in your life. Do I have a witness out there? I've said it before and I'm going to say it again. I love my mama. I love my family. I love my children. But I cannot help but to think, if I did not have Christ living inside of me, I would be nothing. If I did not have Christ living inside of me, I would fail. But I thank God today that the blood has benefits. And I'm a firm believer, brothers and sisters, that if you have been washed in the blood of Jesus and he has changed your life, you should shout it to the top of your lungs with vigor and excitement. Did you hear what I said? You should be a witness that God has set you free. You should not be ashamed, brothers and sisters, that once you were in sin, headed to hell, but just like the old folk would say, something got a hold to you and it snatched you out of what you were in. You shouldn't be ashamed to tell the world, yeah, I was the one that should have died, but the grace and mercy of God found me in the nick of time. You should not be ashamed, brothers and sisters, to talk about the righteousness of Christ. And some folk, brothers and sisters, if I could be truthful, are afraid to let the world know that their blood washed and saved, in fear of how other people will feel about them, how they would try to box them in and say, oh, you a holy roller. Yes, I am. I'm rolling holy. Yes, I am. I'm not ashamed to tell people that God has set me free. And I'd rather lose some friends and gain Jesus. I'd rather let some people go and gain Jesus, because I know that his blood has benefits. His blood has benefited my life. Let me hurry along to the text. We find here in the Hebrew writer is writing an illustration for us to show us how the blood, how blood has the element of redemptive purposes. It was the responsibility, brothers and sisters, of the priests in biblical times and back in the day for the priests and the high priest to offer sacrifices to atone the wrongs of the people annually. They would have to go into the holy place. They would have to go into the tabernacle. And every year they would have to offer sacrifices and plead to God and pour blood on the altar. They would have to sacrifice and cleanse the whole temple with blood. They would take the blood of goats and calves, and the priest would offer sacrifices for the sins, and only the high priest could enter into the most holy place. It was the high priest's responsibility to go into the most high place, brothers and sisters. And brothers and sisters, what would happen if the priest had any sin in his life? They would tie a rope around his waist, and if he had sin in his life, when he got into the most holy place, place, he would drop dead and they would have to drag his body out. That was the process that they had to go through for the atoning of sin. That was the process year after year they would go through. But look what the writer says here in verse 11. But when Christ came as high priest, his divine nature superseded the ability of the human priest. You see, when Christ became the high priest, the text teaches us that he only had to go in one time. Lord have mercy. I wish some of y'all could really get that. He didn't have to go in time after time, year after year, but he had to go in just one time. That's the power of the blood of Christ. That's the power of Jesus, is that he went in one time for all of us. He went in one time for the generations coming behind us. He went in one time that you and I could be set free from our sins. We were not born yet. We wasn't even a thought in our daddy's mind, but God knew that Jesus had enough power to go in one time that each one of us could be saved. He became the high priest, and no longer would a priest be required to offer any more sacrifices, because Jesus laid down his life one time. It satisfied the requirement that God had to redeem mankind. The other sacrifices only made people ceremonially clean and cleansed on the outside, but when Jesus died, when he gave up his blood, it cleaned us from the inside out. Lord have mercy. I don't just look saved on the outside, but how many people can say I'm saved from the inside out? The blood of Jesus flows in my body and makes me clean. What a gift, brothers and sisters. What a benefit we received when Jesus laid down his life. What a benefit. That's why we have Communion Sunday. That's why we come and we don't worry about how cold it is. We don't worry about the temperature. We're thanking God today that we are saved and that his blood has washed us clean. His blood has set us free. Well, you're looking at me, you're saying, Pastor, can you just give me something to hold on to? Can you tell me what are the benefits of being saved? And I got three simple things I need to tell you, and then I'm through preaching. The first thing I need to tell you, the benefit of being saved is it restores our relationship. Did you hear what I said? It restores our relationship. Don't you know that the Bible says that God loves us so much, he wanted a relationship with each of us, but because mankind allowed sin to creep into their life, that God had to separate himself from mankind. He wanted us, brothers and sisters, to be so close to him that day after day he would give us instructions on how to live. He wanted to be so close, but one day we allow our own consciousness, we allow our own thinking to separate us from God. I tell people all the time, and I want you to really pick this up and put it in your mind and your spirit. If there's a problem between you and God, it's never God's fault. It's always us who mess up. Amen, somebody. It's always us who fail. It's always us who come short of the glory of God. But verse 15 in our text says, Christ is the mediator of a new covenant. Christ, when he came, brothers and sisters, and walked the earth, he became our propitiation. He became our mediator. He became our go-between, so that when God looks at us, he does not see our sins. He does not see our shortcomings. He does not see our mistakes, but all God sees is the blood of Christ that has washed us clean. You wonder why this preacher pushes people being saved? You wonder why this preacher pushed people being set free and washed in the blood of Jesus? I push this because anybody can be a church member. Anybody can join the church, but it takes a special somebody to surrender their life to the blood of Jesus Christ. It takes somebody with a willing heart to yield themselves to the Spirit of God and commit themselves to God. And when we allow Christ's blood to wash us clean, it restores our relationship with God. It puts us in right position with God. It allows God to be our Father. Father. It allows God to control our life. And do I have a witness? There's no better life lived than the one lived with God talking with you. There's no better life lived than God walking with you. There's no better life lived than God giving you directions. I don't know who I'm preaching to out here, but I need to tell you, if you're not saved, it's time to get right with God. It's time to give your life to God, because that relationship with God is second to none. God can move on your heart. God can change you. God can put you on a straight path. You just got to let the relationship be restored. It restores our relationship, but not only that, brothers and sisters, it not only restores our relationship, but it returns us to a rightful place. I said it returns us to a rightful place. The benefit of the blood, it returns us to a rightful place. The Bible says in Psalms 8, what is man that you're so mindful of him? That you have thoughts of him. The question came to God, what is so special about man? What God did for us, brothers and sisters, when he created everything in the earth, the Bible says in Genesis that he spoke to that which it came from. But when God created us, he spoke to himself. He created us out of himself, which means that we are special to God. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I feel you pulling on my spirit. You've been down and out. You've been doubting yourself. You've been feeling worthless and down and trodden. You've been feeling like life has gotten the best of you. But I need you to do something for me today. Will you just touch yourself on the heart and say, I'm special to God. I mean something to God. I don't know who I'm preaching to. Maybe you're sitting in your car and tears are streaming down your face. Maybe you got some situations going on in your life that seem like you should give up on your hopes and dreams. But the Lord sent me here to tell you that all you got to do is remind yourself that I'm special to God. When God made you, you were not a mistake. When God made you, you were not just a one-night stand. But when God made you, he put purpose in your life. When God made you, he put destiny in your life. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I don't care where you came from. It's all about where you're going. It's all about what you allow God to do in your life, because God has made you to be special. God has made you to be unique. And it's time for you to get in your right place with God. It's time for you to stop allowing people to dictate to you what you can be and where you can go. And say that the only voice that matters right now is what God has to say about me. I'm coming to pull on your faith to let you know you are special to God. You don't have to keep putting needles in your arm. You don't have to put cocaine up your nose, but you can be special to God. Don't you know the God that delivered in the past is the same God that can deliver you now, because you are special to God. You're special. You're special. And there was a position, there is a place that God wants you to live in. But you just got to make up in your own mind that I'm going to live for God. I want to be in my rightful place. Those who are called by God, they receive a promised eternal inheritance. There are blessings that are associated with those of you and those of us who are washed in the blood of Jesus. We go back to our right place. We become all that God wants us to be. God restores, the benefit of the blood is it restores our relationship. It returns us to a rightful place. But watch this. The last thing I need to tell you, the benefits of the blood is this. It releases us from sin. It releases us from sin. The text says when Christ dies, he dies as a ransom. He dies as a payment to set us free from sins that we've committed. He died. He paid the price. He paid the price and set us free from the sins that we committed. I have a whole lot of friends in my life, and I have some good friends. But brothers and sisters, I don't know too many people that would jump in front of a bullet for me. I have a whole lot of friends, but I don't know too many people who would sacrifice their own life for me. But I'm so glad that years ago I found a friend in Jesus. That when I didn't have enough sense to love myself, he loved me enough. Y'all don't hear me preaching out there. I said he loved me enough to die on a rugged cross that I might have a right to live. I know the sins that I committed. I don't need nobody to tell me what I've done wrong. I know what I did. Do you know what you did? I know my mistakes. But I'm so glad that when Christ died, he threw my sins as far as the east is from the west. I'm so glad that the sins that I have committed in my life, because I'm covered in the blood of Jesus. Because the blood of Jesus is working in my life. Because the blood of Jesus has made me whole. Those sins are gone. Brothers and sisters, if you hadn't been released from your sin, you don't know what true freedom is. If you're still going through and you're constantly reminded of the mistakes of your past, you don't know what true freedom is. But I'm glad that Jesus' blood has washed me free. I'm glad today that his blood has made me whole. I'm glad that my sins do not have a grip on my life. But I'm covered under the blood of Jesus. I'm covered being in his precious blood. Brothers and sisters, I close today by just telling you a simple story. I'm through preaching today. But I remember when David Yon, my oldest son, was about 2 years old. I remember, brothers and sisters, him at the house, and it was around Christmas time, Miss Gladys, and what I was doing. I was in there putting up the Christmas tree in the house, and David Yon wanted to help his daddy, so he grabbed a plug, and he tried to plug some lights up in the plug, and his little hand got caught between the socket and the plug, and he burnt his hand, and I got so nervous and scared, because I just said, Lord, they're going to take me to jail, because I done let my son get in trouble. Y'all don't know how that feels. And I rushed to my mom, and I told my mom, I said, Mom, we got to take Davion to the hospital because he has burnt his hand. He has messed his hand up bad. And me and my mother got in the car, and we went to the hospital. We went to the ER department, and when we got to the emergency room, the doctor looked at his hand, and she went in the drawer, and she pulled out some tools and some gloves and some scrubs, and she began to scrub on his little hand. She began to just scrub it very fiercely, and Davion was hollering, and I was hollering because he was hurting. He was in pain, and I looked at the doctor. I said, Doctor, do you have to scrub his hand so hard? Do you have to put so much force on his bruised hand? Do you have to scrub the skin so hard? And the doctor looked at me and she said, Mr. Cunningham, it's necessary for me to scrub his hand so hard because I got to get the dead skin off. I got to get the dead skin off so that new blood can flow in his hand. She said, the only way that he can be healed is that blood starts flowing in his hand. And I've come to let somebody know today, you've been having some burnt up situations. You've been having some hard times in life. But God sent me here today to tell you there's benefit when you let the blood start flowing. If you want your life to be made new, you got to let the blood start flowing. If you want to be made over, you got to let the blood start flowing. Because the question was asked, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. It's nothing. I said it's nothing but the blood. There's benefit in the blood flowing. It's benefits in letting the blood flow. You want your life better? Let the blood flow. Let it wash you. Let it make you whole. Somebody under the sound of my voice right now, you've been needing your life to be refreshed and made new. I'm telling you, this, it's in the blood. The power is in the blood. Did you hear what I said? The deliverance is in the blood. You need your family to get right? It's in the blood. You need your children to act better? It's in the blood. You need your relationship with your spouse to get better? It's in the blood. But you got to give it space and room to flow so the blood can make you better. There's benefits of the blood. How much more? The text says, how much more? Then will the blood of Christ,
He, through his eternal spirit, offer himself unblemished to God. Cleanse our consciousness from acts that lead to death so that we may serve the living God. I don't know about you, but y'all, but I thank God for his blood. Anybody out there with me today? Any blood-washed believers out there today? Listen, I dare you just to give God a praise. Not for a house, not for a car, but thank God for the blood. Anybody just want to take a moment? Hallelujah. Blood-washed believers and say, I thank God for his blood that came streaming down for me. It was blood that made the difference. It's the blood that washes us. If you're watching or you're here today, listen to me very carefully, and you've never accepted Jesus Christ. You've never accepted Jesus Christ. You've mastered church, and there's a whole lot of folk who have mastered church. You know how to pick them up and put them down. You're two-step better than it was when it was in the club. You've got it. You know how to sing. You know the right time to lift up hands. You know all of that church stuff. But you've never surrendered to Jesus Christ. You've never gave him that space he needs in your heart. You never said, God, I want to be cleansed from the inside out. I don't want just an outwardly appearance of being saved. I really want to be saved. If you're watching or you're here today and you've never said yes to Jesus, today is a good day. Somebody shout, today is a good day. It's a good day. It's the right time. It's the right moment for you to say yes to Jesus Christ. All you have to do is just pray this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I invite you into my heart to be my Lord and to be my Savior. I admit that I've made some mistakes. I've done some wrong. I've messed up, God. But today I realize that I can be saved. Today I realize that I can be made whole. I'm asking you, Jesus, to come into my heart and to make me whole and clean. Wash me, Lord, from the inside out. I want to be new. I want to be whole. Father, occupy every area of my life that I can live for you. In Jesus' name, amen. Look, if you prayed that prayer, I'm telling you right now, that is the beginning of your process. But you've got to get connected to the body of Christ. And I'm sorry, I may get in trouble for this, but I ain't scared of trouble. I don't preach a whole lot of doctrine and denominational stuff. I preach kingdom. Because I believe the kingdom of God is what's really more important than anything else. That God reigns and super reigns over us and controls us. I believe in my church. I love my church. I believe it is a great institution. But I believe also that God's kingdom is where we should reside, where we should live. We should be brothers and sisters by faith and live together. And listen, I'm telling you, you need to be connected to the kingdom of God. You need to be connected to the church. You need to be connected to what God is doing. You've got to associate yourself with people who are trying and striving for the same goal you are. And if you're not connected to a church, I'm telling you, let's get connected. Let's get connected so that we can grow by grace together. You can help me and I can help you, and we become better in the Lord. Be connected that we can learn from each other. And if you need connection today, I want to offer China Grove. We're not a perfect church, but we're a church that's trying to do what God has called us to do. We're just trying to live for the Lord. And if you want to be around like-minded people, I invite you, if you need to join virtually or you're here, come and be a part of what we're doing here at China Grove. Amen and amen. I thank God for the blood because it made the difference at Calvary. We're getting ready to prepare ourselves to take the Lord's Supper today. And I want everybody, I invite everybody to take the Lord's Supper today. Matters not where you come from, matters not what church you are associated with. All are invited to the Lord's table today. The scripture teaches us that if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the propitiation of our sin. And not for our sins only, but for the sins of the whole world. Wherefore, you that truly and earnestly repent of your sin and are in love and charity with your neighbor. Y'all know I take that seriously. If you got something going on with somebody, look around and say, we need to get this right. Love and charity with your neighbor and intend to lead a new life, walking henceforth in a new way. The scripture says we draw near with faith and we take the Holy Sacrament to our comfort. Everybody is welcome to take communion today as we prepare ourselves for communion. We all sing that one time together.
I thank God for the blood that came streaming down for me. It was the blood that made the
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thine divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and heartfully sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past. And grant that we may ever serve and please thee in the newness of life to the honor and glory of thy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of thy great mercy have promised forgiveness of sins to all them with hearty repentance and true faith, turn unto thee. Have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all of our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom our hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secret is hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy holy table, O Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies.
We are not worthy so much as to gather the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is to always have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may live and grow thereby, and that being washed through his most precious blood, we evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy did give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute in his holy gospel, command us to continue perpetual memory of his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we humbly beseech thee. Grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat. This is the body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this. For this is the blood of the New Testament, which is shed for the remission of sin. Do this as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. Amen. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. As pastor of this church, I come and I'm first partaker today of this communion. I thank God for giving me this opportunity, for him giving his life for me, and I take this bread with gladness of heart. Likewise, I take the cup of his most precious blood, shared for me at Calvary for the remission of my sin. I thank God for Jesus, and I take it with gladness of heart. My sister, before you is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ given for you. You may take and eat ye all of it. Likewise, before you use the cup of his most precious blood, shared for you at Calvary's cross, you may take and drink ye all of it. Let us all together say it is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should all times and all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and our angels, and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Amen. Amen. We're going to come and we're going to serve everybody. We're going to serve everybody in their cars. We're going to serve everybody under the tent. We ask that you do not take your communion until we're able to read the ritual and we'll do it together. We ask that you would hold your communion until we can read the ritual and do it together. Reverend Davis and myself will come and serve everybody. Please be patient with us. Amen. Thank you.
your key. There's power in the blood, power in the blood.
My brothers and sisters, before you is the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is given for thee to preserve thy soul and body unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. Likewise, before you, the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee to preserve thy soul and body unto everlasting life. Drink this in remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee, and be thankful. I invite you now to whisper a prayer of thanksgiving in your hearts. Amen. Let us together, brothers and sisters, pray the prayer that Jesus, when his disciples asked, "Master, teach us to pray," he taught them to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory." Amen. Listen, I invite you now to pass the peace. Just wave at somebody and tell them, "Peace be unto you." Pass the peace around. Amen. God bless you. Listen, as we said, on next Sunday, it's supposed to be extremely cold on next weekend, extremely cold. So we're going to go ahead and start preparing ourselves for inside. You are invited. You are invited. We just ask that you will register on our website or through Eventbrite. Amen. Amen. And please, please, please come and share in the worship with us. Now unto him who is, let me say before I get a benediction. I saw a truck drive by. I don't know who was in the truck, but they drove by and they dropped off some gifts or something that our trustees have out there for you as you depart. Pick up whatever gift that was, amen, and be blessed, amen? Amen. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his throne with exceeding grace, joy. To the all-wise God, our Father, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power. Henceforth, now, and forever, let every heart say amen, amen, and amen. Thank God for the blood. Amen. God bless you all.